Hi guys, it's Kelly here. I'm back with another video. Today we are going to be using some Ulta new products, golden feathers, stamps, and dies, as well as the peony spray, which I stole part of my sentiment from. And this is actually part of a blog hop. I'm a day late editing this video because if you had not noticed, it is long, as long as so long. Get the wines, get the coffees, get the popcorn. We're going to be a minute. Ulta new has released refills for all of their artist markers, which if you're like me, and you have all of the artist markers, this is fantastic. So you don't have to worry about like running out of your favorite color and having to, you know, buy the marker. So basically this is me just the packaging, the way that it comes is it's boxed and then it has the plastic wrap over it. I will tell you, I'm working on Yupo paper because I wanted to do a technique in the background with the refills and see if it worked. So it's gonna be a minute. This is a long one, but I just wanted to touch on, so if you have Copic markers, like I have Copic markers, a Copic refill is about $5.25-ish for 25 milliliters. The Ulta new refills are slightly more expensive. They are $6, but you get 30 milliliters. So for 75 cents, you're getting an extra, you know, 5 milliliters. Anyway, just for the price point there. Also, there is a sale on the artist marker. So if you always wanted them, they are currently having a sale, but the sale only goes through the 22nd. And since I'm late getting this video up, I wanted to tell you up front in case you were trying to go get you some markers. What else? Oh, the golden feather set that I'm using here, the stamps and the dies. If you buy the bundle, that's also on sale right now as well, 15% off. So if you get both of them, they're $42. This stamp set it's huge. It's a very, very large stamp set. And you can tell, like, because from the card, that's a full-size card and that feather's almost, I mean, I think it's like 4 inches. Anywho, but if you buy them together, instead of paying $42, you can pay like 34 and some change, so roughly $35 in case you really, really love those. They're really great for masculine cards if you have a lot of those that you make. Okay, done with that now, moving on. So I just put some rubbing alcohol on because there isn't a mixative. This is not what their intended purpose is for. Their intended purpose is to fill your markers, but I was just having some fun playing around. I wanted to see what the colors looked like, and so that's why I started doing this kind of rainbow background. When I did the Forest Glades, you can see, for some reason, and I am not sure what the reason is, it left like little pock marks, almost like granulation from, you know, sometimes you get that with watercolors sometimes, like where it gets granulated. So that one did look like that. I tried moving that around, seeing what I could do with it. My original intention for this was to do the gold foiling trick. If you have not seen alcohol inks with gold foiling, I did a video. I will link to that. It's super cool. That was my original intention. First things first, if you use rubbing alcohol versus using the Ranger alcohol mixative, it takes a lot longer to dry. It just does. I don't know what that is because normally alcohol evaporates really quickly, so it must just be something with the inks mixing in there. It takes a lot longer to dry. Also, I should have left well enough alone. I can't stop myself. Like in doing these, like I just want to keep adding things. My first mistake was not working on my Ranger craft mat. I am working on my like grid pad from Simon Says Stamp. See this blue mark? Get used to a lot of those because I'm pretty sure I soaked through like 16 pages and I'm not buying a new one, folks. Mm-mm, child, no. I'm using this thing, so get used to these big blue marks you're about to see. When I pictured these little feathers, I pictured them like coral, teal, with some gold accents. That was my original intention. So this is the teal portion of it. I used Ocean Waves, Desert Night, stand by. Yep, oh look it, I do know my stuff. And Persian Blue, that's a lie, I don't really know my stuff. Like, don't come here expecting me to know things, I'm a hot mess. Anyway, so you can see there's a ton of ink on here, ton of alcohol, just kind of moving that around with a straw. I did notice that these were a little bit more difficult to move than regular alcohol inks, but not impossible. You just have to play with it a little bit more. And this was really just an experimentation. I had not ever tried this, you know, with these particular refills before. I have tried Copic refills, and those also took longer to dry. And the traditional alcohol inks, I've tried. So this was just something new. So I decided that since it was taking forever to dry, I would just kind of help it along with my heat gun. I do not know what happened here, folks. I honestly have no idea. It must be the way that the ink and the, or maybe it's just the alcohol. I'm not really sure, but somehow I managed to make this thing dry matte. Now, Yupo is glossy paper. That's why it works that way. Somehow I have created this completely matte background, which is really kind of cool, I gotta tell ya, because, you know, a lot of times with glossy cardstock, you know, with alcohol inks, everything is glossy. The downside is the foil trick that I wanted to use don't really work. So I kept trying, it wasn't working. So I thought, well, maybe it's because I heat set it. Maybe that's why it went matte. So this one I had been letting dry off to the side. So I'm like, I'll try the gold foil with that, because we're nothing if not craft scientists, right? Right. So I tried it with this and no, still no. So, and then I got this like weird black, like dark line. So I just dropped some more alcohol on that, to break up that line. So maybe I can use that background for something different later, because I'm a cheap chicken and I paid for that piece of paper. See what I'm saying? So this one I'm just going to set aside. Maybe we'll see that background, another time. Not really sure, but now I'm committed to this teal one. And this is another new to me thing that I wanted to try. I've laid out my feathers in my Misty, and I recently purchased this alcohol lift ink from Tim Holtz. You've probably seen it just about everywhere in the craft community. It's like a pretty popular item right now, and I wanted to give it a try because I do think that the whole concept of it is super cool, which is basically you ink up with this ink, anti-ink? I don't even know what you call it. Anyway, it's a clear ink, and then you stamp it down on an alcohol background, and it lifts up the ink, leaving you this, like, ghost white image, which is super cool. I didn't get good pressure on that bottom one because I was lazy. I didn't get up out of my chair. You know me, I always got to do it the hard way. So got back up, pushed that down. That's all good. And just really the whole idea was super cool. What I learned, what did I learn? I learned a lot of things in this video, for real. I learned that you have to make sure that you clean off your stamps really good, because when you put this ink pad back on there, it will reactivate the alcohol ink. And then instead of lifting with it, you will stamp it down. If you've watched any of Jennifer McGuire's videos on this, like, she's amazing, love her. You know that if when you pick it back up, like if I had put a clean piece of paper in there and then wanted to stamp that blue ink, I totally could. It stays wet on there. In the Golden Feathers stamp set, there are a couple detail layers, which are just a lot of fun. I just think that they're so fun to add in there. And so I wanted to do some of those in this background. I just picked a couple. I didn't want every single feather to have detail on it. I just wanted a couple of them to have a little bit something different and kind of break up that background. So again, using that alcohol lift ink to do that. This is a long video because we're gonna talk about this card, but then we're also going to have story time. So hang tight because it's going to be worth it. So here is where things start to kind of go awry. It's still sticky. That's this issue. So I've cut it down to the size that I want, and then the paper was still sticky. And since I couldn't gold foil it to make it unsticky, I just tried using my embossing powder bag, and that seemed to work relatively well. I'm going now to stamp down these two feathers. These are going to be part of my focal point that we're creating. And I'm using fog ink from Simon Says Stamp because I wanted it to be more of a no-line coloring look. I wanted like neutral feathers with gold accents on this teal background. The coral thing just didn't work out for me. Just didn't work out for me. And that's totally cool because we have to be adaptable. I am using the warm grays from the Artist Marker Set B for this because this is going to be my, like I said, my neutral. And I stamped these on Nina 80-pound solar white cardstock. The whole technique, and you're going to see it like 800 times because this is where we're going to have story time. The whole technique is basically using the brush tip. I didn't use the bullet nib, but if that works for you, you totally can. To use the brush tip and a flicking motion. So like just the tip of the marker, just barely touching your page. And we're going to create those, that feather-like texture. So, you know, just going through, putting in those lines. Sometimes I'm coming out from like the center of the quill. Sometimes I'm coming in from the outside edge of the feather. I was die cutting these, so I didn't go over the line. But if you were not die cutting them, these would look uber cool. Like just so cool with a no line coloring look that you went out over the line. So they would look super realistic. I am starting with my lightest color. I'm going to work out to my darkest color. I am doing the same thing every time. Every time. Now, let's have story time. If you follow me on Instagram, you know, well, if you follow me here, you know I've been having this bug spider problem. If you follow me on Instagram, you already know what I'm going to tell you because I share things on my story all the time. If you don't follow me on Instagram, by all means, please do. Also, that will be very helpful to me because once I hit 10,000 followers, which I'm about, I don't know, maybe 1,500 shy of, I'll be able to share like the videos and stuff in my stories. But anyway, only if you have Instagram, like don't go out of your way. I don't even know which one to start with. There's so many spider stories, just so many. They're everywhere. I don't understand. I've tried the I tried the peppermint mixed with water, spraying that. No go. That didn't work. I came home from work. I'll just start with the first one. I came home from work the other day, and I walked into the back door, and as I opened the back door, on the wall is this big, ginormous spider. Just this big, ginormous spider. And I'm on the phone, and I'm like, oh my word, like there's this huge spider. Why are these monsters living in my house? I do not understand what is happening here. I'm trapped. I'm like, I can't even go in there. And I'm on the phone. I'm like, where are you? Like, can you come kill this thing? And my dog comes out, you know, cause I'm coming home from work. She's excited to see me. My dog comes around the corner. As the dog comes around the corner, this ginormous spider plops. That is not a sound I'm making up. Okay. It plops to the ground and starts running. Well, I can't lose it because what's worse than finding a spider is losing one in your house. Because then all night long, you have to wonder where it's at. You know, it's terrifying. Anywho, so it starts running. I have the spider spray in my hand and I start spraying the spider as it is running. I am screaming the entire time. I'm yelling. I am yelling at the spider as I'm spraying the spider because I don't know. That was just my initial reaction. My cavewoman reaction, apparently. So I spray it and I'm, guys, like I cannot even tell you. Like the spider was so large that in the area, because when you spray the spider spray, it turns white and it turns the spider white. In the area that had turned white on my floor, you could literally see the outline of that spider's body. It was so large, I could see its crime scene photos. Like I could see it. Like, you know how they chalk outline? This was the outline of the spider. So then he kept running anyway, and then went into the closet, and then it was a whole big to-do trying to find the carcass to make sure that the spider was dead. The spider was dead, by the way. Then, spider number, well, then there was two more that we had to kill later on in the day. So three spiders for that day. Then yesterday I was vacuuming. My vacuum has a setting for bare floors, so I was vacuuming my kitchen. Well, the other night I had made like frozen vegetables, and apparently when I went to go throw away the top of the bag, I missed the garbage can, and it was laying underneath like the little outcropping of where the cupboards are. And so I see that, and as I approach it, it starts to move. Also on Instagram, because all you could see was like two hairy little legs sticking out from behind the thing. So I tell my son to stay on the couch. I'm like, Peanut, you stay on the couch, preparing to fight for my life with this enormous, giantress spider. And as I am gearing up to how I'm going to, I don't even know, murder this thing, it runs out from behind the bag, behind my dishwasher. And I'm like, you see, nothing worse than losing one. So immediately I grab the little peppermint oil, I put that on a pad, and I shove the pad over to where it entered behind the dishwasher. Side note about this card. Altenew doesn't have a colorless blender, so I used my Copic one to clean up the quill in the center, and then I'm adding in some highlights with a white gel pen. So that's spider story number two. I have spider story number three, but I don't think we're going to get to it before I have to tell you how bad this card went. So I will save that for the next video. It's a good one. I promise. You'll want to come back for that. So there's, like I said, there's three detail layers. The one on the left here with the little dots is not actually meant for that feather, but I wanted to use it anyway. The heart wants what the heart wants, guys. So I'm just going to adjust it to be able to fit the feather that I want. Embossing buddy bag, because I am doing some gold heat embossing. I'm going to stamp this down in Versamark ink after I drop the ink pad. I'm telling you, this was like the smoothest card ever. I hope you're fluent in sarcasm, because it was not smooth at all. It was a disaster. Now, a lot of people very sweetly on my blog said, I don't even know what you're talking about. This card is beautiful. I don't see where anything went wrong. I assure you, it did. But you know my motto, we're not starting over. And this one really tested me, like really, really tested me. So I'm using gold embossing powder from Hero Arts because I really love that whole teal gold like look that you can get. And as you can see, the one that's little polka dotted, it hangs over the edge. I'm just going to knock that off with a paintbrush so that it perfectly fits my feather. And then I'm going to heat emboss it. Metallic. I mean, heat embossing is fun anyway. It's like super magical to watch it all melt. And I've been doing it for years and I still absolutely adore it. But there is something about a metallic embossing or a glitter embossing powder that just makes it like extra cool to watch. So embossing both of those sides. Then I think, ooh, I want some gold splatters in the background. But it's on Yupo, so I probably won't be able to use perfect pearls. I'll emboss with water. Because you can do that. I don't know if you know that. You can emboss with water. But I didn't think about the fact that that background is still sticky. Remember how we talked about that? Well, guess what? It is. Now wait. So it adhered to the spatters, but it also adhered to the sticky parts of the background. So I'm looking at it and I'm like, you know what? It's more gold than I wanted, but it's not awful. Like, I'm just going to go ahead and heat set it. So that's what I do. And now the first time I heat dried it and it was fine. There was no issue. This time I have no idea what the difference is. I honestly don't. Like the embossing powder, I don't know if it just got too hot. Wait for it. And oh, there it is. Yeah. What happened there? Paper totally curled and it just keeps curling. Like you could see in the back of it. You could see in the back of it where it was like puckering. It was so bad. So I'm just going to work with it. I turn it over, like, because traditionally with regular paper, if you heat it from the backside, you can get some of the warping to let go. I try heating it from the backside. That does not work. My next game plan is, well, I warped it with heat. Maybe I can smooth it with heat. So I put it in between two pieces of copy paper, turned off the steam on my iron, and I ironed it. Yes, that removed most of my embossing. Straight up, it did. But it also flattened it out. Can you see that little puckered left-hand side? It also flattened it out quite a bit. The other thing that I tried to do was run it through my Big Shot. So I put a piece of paper over it to basically to like protect it. And then I ran it through my Big Shot a couple of times. This gave me a relatively flat panel. I mean, it's not perfect. It's not perfectly flat. It's still not perfectly flat. But putting it on the white fun foam, which is what I'm doing here, will also help to keep it more flat. So the right-hand side raised up, but the left-hand side sunk in. And I thought at first it was going to be fine. Like, I was just going to be able to accept that that's what it looked like. Turns out, no, I couldn't do it. So I ended up propping up the left-hand side with two layers of Scotch foam tape, which lifts it up actually slightly higher than the white fun foam. And that balanced it out a little bit more. So that was a good idea too. That worked. I adhered my, I guess more round feather down flat with Tombow Mono multi-glue, and then I popped the other one up on foam. I'm going to use warm wool ink from W+9. It dries like a very warm gray to stamp out this hello from the Golden Feather set. It has three very large sentiments in it, which I really like because, you know, I like to have a large one and then a little one, like a little label one. That's just, I don't know, where I'm living at these days. So I stamped this down twice, and then I didn't want to use black. I wanted there to be a darker piece, but I didn't really have a gray that matched. This is where, again, inks, alcohol markers, all of those things are fantastic to custom color. So I just used the WG07. So it's the darkest one to color like a little corner of my white Nina cardstock. And then I'm going to heat emboss the rest of the sentiment on there. So the card will say, hello, you look beautiful today. Because honestly, people, can we just, who would not want to receive that card in the mail? Like so often, I think, you know, we just get so caught up in the doing. And even I try to go out of my way to be like super encouraging to other people. But, even I sometimes forget that, you know, being complimentary and telling people, like if you see somebody in the grocery store and you love their nail polish or their lipstick or whatever the thing is, like they have a totally banging outfit on, like tell them. Everybody likes to get a compliment. So in case nobody has complimented you today, let me be the first to tell you, you look beautiful today. And I don't care if you're sitting at home in your pajamas. I don't care if it's midnight and you've been drinking red wine for the last 3 hours and your teeth are stained. I don't care if you haven't brushed your hair or your teeth today, because being beautiful is not just how you look. It's not. And I really have, I have such a wonderful group of followers. You guys are so encouraging in the comments you leave. You know, they touch my heart. And if I have not, I'm gonna get all emotional. Anyway, if I do not do a good job of letting you know, I genuinely appreciate you and the encouragement and the prayers and the love that you guys offer me. So thank you so much. I accented this with some gold sequins from Neat and Tangled. And, you know, I like to put that little glossy accents in there to make sure that they stay where they're supposed to stay. And then that's the whole card. So again, hit up the sales before the 22nd if you want the markers. And that's it. I will be back really soon with another video, guys. Thanks for stopping by. I'll catch you on the next one. Bye.